Calm down. It's okay. It's okay. You're safe.
It's out there. It attacked us. The dog saved us. Poor little dog. And we...
You're fine. You're safe. You understand? Hey, look at me. Now, your mother sent me. She's looking for you. Okay, come out.
It's back. I'm not coming out. Shut the door. Shut it.
Okay, stay here. I'll go check.
Don't leave me!
Just keep that door shut. Come on out. It's over now. You're safe.
You sure? sure it's dead?
Yeah. Now, what were you two doing here in the first place?
We were just walking, and we heard barking, and went in.
But your brother said you were playing with the dog, and then it ran in there.
Yes, that's what I meant.
Mo, whatever it is you've done, I won't judge you. Everyone makes mistakes.
I'm not lying. I'm telling the truth. We came here because the dog, he attacked the thing. Buddy saved us. Otherwise, we would have...
There's nothing we can do for him now.
You don't understand. It's our fault. We chased him in here because we were hunting him.
Wait, hunting? The dog? Why the hell would you hunt a dog?
For Mom. For her birthday. We don't have nothing. Not even anything to eat. But we didn't want her to go hungry. Not on her birthday. And when we saw the dog playing with this kid, Dominic, we... Well, got an idea.
All right, turn around and don't look. It's over now. Get back to your mom.
Where have you been all day? This ridiculous
I was cleaning out this one place.
And? Was it worth it?
You know, this used to be a bell tower in the Middle Ages.
I remember cleaning out a furniture store last year.
Electrician, not a carpenter.
How may I help you? Happy to trade. Good for you. Discerning eye. Let's do this again.
Even if it's true, so what?
Say what you want.
But we won't get anything done here. You give up too quickly.
I wonder what the hell is going on in the central loop since PK's restricted access.
Get ready!
Better just give it up, asshole.
Die!
Gotcha.
Not a good time, Dominic. Please, leave my boys alone.
But what if something happened to him? We gotta do something. Scott! Mo! Say something. I'm asking nicely. Please?
Look, maybe your uncle can buy you a pet or something. He seems like a man of some means. Now, leave my boys alone.
Hey, it's you, mister. You seen Buddy anywhere?
Wait, so you haven't told him anything yet? I'm sorry, kid. Buddy's dead. But he died saving your friends.
They only just told me themselves. We didn't know how to tell you. That's why I asked you to leave. I didn't mean to be so harsh. It's just such a shock. I'm sorry. Dominic, I... Thank you for protecting my sons. And Dominic. He's so young. As for you, maybe you pilgrims aren't just criminals after all. Here you go. You take care now.
Sometimes I wake up at night and forget the fall even happened. That's about the only time I smile. But then I see the goddamn UV lights.
The first tournament in 3 years. They'll attract the toughest fighters in the city.
I'm from PK Pen. We'll never finish with you coming back every 4 minutes.
Come on, Aiden, go to the... this place to
about time, Sophie.
The finest merch stuff around.
Oh, watch out for that, my boy.
Oh.
Water tower, Dad.
I wonder what the hell is going on in the central loop since PK is restricted access.
Boy would turn things around.
Never out of stock. Gerard was a great man. He shall now live forever in our
pass this way.
Somebody's having a good day, huh?
Oh, boy, am I ever. Come on, take a sniff.
Wait, a sniff of what?
Exactly. The stench is gone, innit? So how do I smell? More lily or lilac, would you say?
I don't know, lilac?
Lilac. That's my Madeline's favorite scent.
Madeline?
Finally, I can approach the most wonderful lady in the world without shame. And it's all thanks to the guy that opened the tap for... Wait a sec. Holy fuck, it's you! You're Aiden!
Maybe.
If that's so, may I ask something of you? There's this certain item I'd like to give my Madeline.
Okay, what?
A red dress from the old clothes shop at the beginning of Station Road in Quarry End. I know how it sounds, but Madeline, she wore a dress like that once. It'll bring back our old memories from before. You know, from before everything. I'll be a geezer before I manage to get in there. You understand?
Meanwhile, some fancy man's been hanging around Madeline.
Right, so you don't have much time.
Exactly. Look, see that picture behind me? It'll show you what you're looking for.
I've never believed the Night Runners were real. Just fairy tales, if you ask me. Aiden, you've been around a while. You're practically one of us now.
Boy here, boy. What you need, buddy? Thanks, man.
About time Sophie grew into the woman her mother was. Used to live above the antique shop on Horseshoe. They were like 80 years old. They were still in love. I wonder what happened to them.
Thank you.
gonna get you.
Hello, my dears. I hope you are holding on in these difficult times. You're healthy and safe, I trust. I am. Life over the past 77 years has tried to kill me time and again. I guess I'm immortal. I live alone in a large house. My beloved wife, Valerie, passed away in 2018. Actually, I'm glad she died then, so that she didn't have to watch the planet go to hell. I have a son, Daniel, who lives with his wife and my three granddaughters in Berlin. But I haven't been able to contact them for months. I'm afraid that they have turned, though perhaps they have gone somewhere and simply have no means of communication. Anyway, if any of you are spending this Christmas alone, I have a large pantry still full of preserves made by my Valerie. And I'm a pretty good cook. Perhaps someone would like to keep me company. May the Holy Child's grace shine upon you. God bless.